Good morning, everyone. Am I audible? Good morning, am I audible? Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Construction. Last class, what we were doing yesterday, we were talking about this construction coordinates. Hello? Hello? Yeah? Solid mechanics, engineering mechanics, and solid mechanics. Yeah, the link is shared already. Yeah, it is in Google Form. Google Form. Yeah, I have already shared the link. Yeah, backlog group. Mm-mm. 9:30, it was sent. Okay. What we were doing? We were doing this construction coordinates, construction coordination. And what was it? There were two methods of coordinating and managing the resources, which to organize in an organized manner with our project partners so that it gives us an efficient work in our project. Right. So for that, there were two methods, which were namely direct contact and meetings. We can coordinate in this way, either by direct contact or by meetings. So in direct contact, what is that? Directly we contact with the concerned persons and then we deal with them. And under direct contact only, it can be your direct contact can be formal or it can be informal. In the formal, there will be documentations, okay, and it is, that's why it is restricted kind of work, because you will have be restricted for all the things like for time at which it is, has to be cleared, it at which time it has to be completed, then the money, everything. So that is restricted here in the formal contact. But in the informal contact, you can contact over phone also, whenever you want. You can contact to the worker and then or the team member and then talk. And then what you can do, you can discuss among yourself that, okay, this on this date, from this week to this week, we can perform this. Or suppose today, I called you, I called one of my group member who is handling or looking after the basement area, or who is looking after the painting portions, who will be looking after the painting portions or the woodworks. So I'll tell that from tomorrow you start your hello. I had sent, but okay, I'll send one more once more. What happened? Sorry, your students are having backlog exams. Okay, so I had to take the call. Okay, so where I was, yeah. Informal contact, what happens here is that informally at any time you can call over telephone and discuss the matter and then decide, come to a decision right away there. And also your you don't need to gather for systematically for your documentation or for your starting the work. You can just gather information, you can gather the information very quickly without any need of any formal procedures. Okay, then we have, this was there are two methods of construction coordination. What was that? Your direct contact and your meetings. Under direct contact, it can be formal, it can be informal. Okay, and the next one was your meetings. Meetings, we talked like what is meetings, like we will call upon the members of the there should be on time to time there should be meetings, okay, for sharing the information of this project site, like what is happening, what is not happening, what is the status of the work. Also, if there is some problems on the site, then how, and if that cannot be handled by you, then through the meeting, what we can do, we can call some expert also, and then we can discuss the matter. So in that way, we can coordinate. When we do the meeting portion, the meeting for coordination, that is a very essential part, because once we do the meeting, we will have face-to-face contact with the concerned persons, and we can go and have the solution to any problem, or we can know what is the real view of the project, like what is happening on the site, how much it has proceeded, how much time it is going to take. All this can be directly discussed over, not over phone, but in a meeting where all the members are present, and we can give the feedbacks, comments, etc. to the team members. Okay. Then we have, for this meetings to be done, we have to schedule the meeting, right? So we have to schedule and unschedule meeting in the design process. Schedule meetings for the design process are conducted at intervals of one a week to report on the progress of the design work and to discuss any issue that arises. Okay, scheduled meetings or design diminishes slowly once the construction stage starts. Okay, so scheduled meetings are what? They transform into an unscheduled meeting if any problem crops. Okay, scheduled meeting, we have scheduled once our construction project is ready, plan is ready. We will discuss that from which this, suppose the foundation work is to be done, which mason is going to be handling this. We have to contact those persons, etc. So we have to schedule different meetings before the construction work takes up the speed, suppose before the beginning of the construction. So obviously we have to plan So we have to schedule meeting accordingly. Suppose in a week, this is per week one meeting, two meeting, in the next third week one meeting, fourth week one meeting, so that we will know that how to proceed. We have to proceed in this way, like we have discussed about the members, which masons we are going to take, what materials are we going to collect, from which place we, from which shop we are going to collect, how much money we are going to give. All those things have to be discussed. So before the building construction starts, there will be scheduled meetings. Okay, for if you want to coordinate the things, because for a project to proceed, you need coordinations, right? Construction coordinate should be there. So once this meetings, once you have planned everything, where to buy, what to buy, whom to give for that work. Okay, so after that, what happens? Once your construction starts, it takes up speed. These meetings can be shortened. Like daily, we used to do the meeting, now like per week, we used to do. So next, when the construction speed takes up, obviously there is nothing to see much because already everything is planned. How to do, when to do. Suppose only the thing when material is short, you have to buy and you have to check the status. So monthly you can do one meeting then. Okay, so scheduled meetings is that. Unscheduled meetings are obviously, you know what is what do you mean by unscheduled meetings. Your meetings can be scheduled or unscheduled. Unscheduled is what you there is a during urgent need, when you have to solve some current issue related to design, then whatever, you have to make a meeting. You will call up your members of the project and you are going to just over the phone also you can have the meeting, or off the without the phone also you can just call up for a meeting, and then they will come and talk over the not over the phone, but they'll come and meet you personally also. And this meeting would be unscheduled, like we have not scheduled beforehand. Like here in the scheduled meeting, we used to schedule per week, every Monday we'll meet or every Tuesday we'll meet. But here in unscheduled, at any time your unscheduled meetings can happen whenever you have any disturbance in the project work, or if you have some very important or urgent needs in your design criteria, you have seen some faults, etc. Okay. So these were your construction coordination methods, how you can coordinate your constructions. Okay, so next, if we go, we have to go to earthworks. So I have, yeah, this one. For earthwork, where is my, okay. Yeah, for this your earthwork, I have taken out this. Now your construction coordination topic is over, but now we are coming to earthwork. Okay. So after construction coordinate, now we are going to talk about the earthworks in our building construction. Okay, what do you mean by now earthwork? In the construction terms, excavation is the process of removing. Earthwork means nothing but your excavations. Okay, removing earth to form a cavity in the ground on small sites or in confined spaces. Okay. One twenty. Rule number 120. Okay, 120 was also given. Sixty-one is done. 88 is done. 101. 57. Roll number 57. Bamam Dad. 57. Unmute yourself. Fifty-seven. Bamam. Zero, 1 8. 119.
ম্যাম, রোল নাম্বার 47। হ্যালো ম্যাম,
83 বাবা, 119. यू आर 47? हेलो,
यस मैम, यस मैम,
47?
यस मैम,
यू रीड दिस पोर्शन इन इंट्रोडक्शन पार्ट. व्हाट
द
डज दिस से?
कंस्ट्रक्शन
47.
ओ सॉरी मैम, माय फादर इज कॉलिंग.
Okay. Then read this, what you understood in your artwork. 028. 028. Tak chum.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Your voice is so low. Okay, who is this? Jocelyn NTP? Jocelyn NTP, what is your roll number?
117, ma'am.
197.
No, no, 117.
117. You read this introduction portion, what you understood by that? For your friends also, you read this.
In construction terms, excavation is the process of removing earth to form a cavity in the ground.
Mm-hmm.
On small sites or in confined spaces, excavation may be carried out by manual means using tools such as picks, shovels, and wheelbarrows. Larger scale excavation works with wheel require heavy plant such as bulldozer and backcatters. For more information, see excavating plan.
Okay. What do you understood? Nothing is simple. You just read the line and just easy to understand, right? 46. 68. It says nothing but tell. Excavation, earthwork means what? It is the removal of earth to form cavities, right?
Removal of land and all.
Yeah, so for small sites where you have, you can use what? You can use manually also using these tools, shovels, wheelbarrows.
Shovels and wheelbarrows.
Yeah, but for large excavations where you have, you want to construct
a... Those are better.
Yeah. Huge construction work, so you will need to, for that, those artworks, you will need what? Bulldozers, back actors, for more information, excavation plans. Okay, so this thing, so you know what is bulldozers, etc., or I need to show?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so next is what? A common method of classification is by the material being excavated. So in earthwork, the excavation portion, how we can, this is also of many types, like based on the material, on the material type, we have, there is a classification of excavation also. Okay, so like topsoil excavation, read this part. Read this, topsoil one, material types. 32, roll number 32.
Yes, ma'am.
Read the material types based on the material. What are your artworks?
Okay, ma'am. And from the beginning of the material types.
Material types. A common method of classification is by material being excavated. Topsoil excavation. This involves the removal of the exposed layer of the earth's surface, including any vegetation or decaying matter, which could make the soil compressible and therefore unsuitable for bearing structural loads. The depth will vary from site to site, but is usually in a range of 150 to 200 millimeters.
What is that? Then we have from after topsoil excavation, earth excavation, muck excavation. Okay. Read the types, material types.
Earth excavation. This involves the removal of the layer of soil directly beneath the topsoil. The removed material, referred to as spoil, is often stockpiled and used to construct embankments and foundations. Rock excavation. This is the removal of material that cannot be excavated without using special excavation methods such as drilling by hand or with heavy machinery, or blasting with explosives. Muck excavation. This is the removal of excessively weighted material and soil that is unsuitable for stockpiling. Unclassified excavation. This is the removal of a combination of the above material, such as where it is difficult to distinguish between material encountered.
Finish. So there are how many types? Like, based on your material type, your earthwork. Earthwork means what? Earthwork means excavation. And based on your type, what is happening? Based on your that means excavation, based on the material type, is how much, how many? Topsoil excavation, earth excavation, rock excavation, muck excavation, and unclassified excavation. And what do you mean by the topsoil excavation? As the name suggests, that means the topsoil layer is removed here, okay, excavated here, where you have this, your vegetation or any kind of decaying matters are lying down, etc. Huge decaying materials are lying down. So that is your removal. When you remove those and excavate those things from the topsoil, that is your topsoil excavation. That is known as your topsoil excavation. Okay. So the depth is usually how much this topsoil excavation is, that is shallow. Obviously, the topsoil we are excavating, so that will be of smaller depth. So it will be from 150 to 300 mm. Okay, that will range generally. Then we have next is our earth excavation, which will obviously show you, which as the name suggests, as the material suggests, which is your earth excavation. That is nothing but the layer of the soil, which directly beneath the topsoil is your earth excavation. It's known as your earth excavation. Okay, for foundation works, the earthwork which we do, our excavation we do to remove those soil which are used for the purpose of construction at a greater depth than your topsoil. Okay, then we have next kind of excavation is what? That is your rock excavation. Okay, so rock excavation, this is that type of excavation where we cannot be using normal bulldozers or hand shovels. Because, you know, rock, obviously, you cannot excavate. Excavate means what? To make cavities. Okay. So, you cannot make that. Obviously, you have to do what? You have to do drilling by hand or by heavy machinery or by blasting it with explosives. Okay. Then only you can excavate this. You cannot do this rock excavation by hand or by normal, which we do, which we use for topsoil or the earth excavations. Then your next is your muck excavation. What is your muck excavation? That is the wet kind of materials which we need to remove. Those are your excavation. There are some sites you will get where your soil is very much wet because they were under the under your this water for many years or something like that. So those kind of wet areas to excavate, those are your known as muck excavation. Okay. Then we have unclassified excavation. Says what? This is the removal of a combination of the above materials, such as where it is difficult to distinguish between the materials encountered. So unclassified excavation, when we say, suppose you have a site where you have a combination of this muck, you have a combination of this muck as well as your rock is present on the site itself. Next to the rock where you want to excavate, next to the rock only you have your muck. Okay, so this is a combination of these two, so we cannot say on the site that your excavation you have done is a rock excavation or muck, because it is done, both are done, rock excavation as well as your muck excavation is done. Or you can say these four are only together, like the topsoil you have excavated, then you have excavated the, then you have done the earth excavation, and then you also have done the rock excavation. So this three, if you on the site itself, if you have this three kind of excavations, that means what? You cannot say that what excavation we have done on this site, topsoil excavation, you cannot say that. So it is a combination of these three. So at that time, what we call it, we call it as a unclassified excavation. Okay, I'll say the roll numbers, okay, whichever which are present, and if you are, your attendance is not given, you just inform me, okay? 112 is present, 95, 61, 88, 109, 85, 14, 92, 63, 87, roll number 4 is present, 18 is present, 19, 68, 66, 13, 90, 84, 75, 51, 120, 47, oh sorry, these are present or not? 57 is present, 119 is present, 28, 117, 107, 46, 49, 32, 11, 23. 112 present. Absent or what?
Yes, 90, ma'am.
Okay, 95. 61.
61 present, ma'am.
88.
Yes, ma'am.
61 present.
Okay, 109. 85. 14.
Ma'am, 14 present.
Okay, 92.
Present, ma'am.
63. 63 is not present. 87.
Yes, ma'am.
Four. Roll number 4.
87, ma'am.
Okay. 4. 18. 19.
4, ma'am.
Okay. 18. 19.
Yes, ma'am. 19.
18 is 18, not ma'am. There. Okay. 68.
18.
68. 66. 13.
13, ma'am.
Okay. 90.
Present, ma'am. 90.
84. 75.
Present, ma'am. 84.
Say, okay. 75.
Present, ma'am.
751. 51. 120.
120.
Ma'am. 47.
Ma'am,
130. Ajay, ma'am. Anyone left out?
Ma'am,
107.
107.
119, ma'am. 119 present.
Ma'am, 51
is present, yeah.
49, ma'am. 49
also present.
Ma'am, roll number 28.
43 is also present.
117.
Yeah, present. Okay, I think I've given to almost everyone.
Ma'am, 32. 120, ma'am.
32, 120 present.
11, ma'am, 11.
11 is given.
Ma'am, 22.
17, ma'am.
17 is given.
Then 46.